Today we our topic is motion and type, and the motion and type first topic came distance. When object travel from A point to B and it covers 7 km in 1 hour, then we can calculate speed by distance upon time. We can put 7 here and time 1 hour, then we can get the speed of a object. It will came 7 km per hour, and the unit of the speed is km per hour. And the we can first of all, we have to know the unit of the distance and time. Distance we will measure in kilometer and also in meter, and time we also measure in hours and second. It depends on the whatever condition is given. And the second topic is displacement. Displacement is the shortest path covered by the body in a given interval of time. As we see, when object is displaced from C to D position. And the third topic is motion. Motion, when object travels from A to B, and then it covers some distance. And how it's covered? It's covered by the motion. As we seen here, a motorcycle is at A position. It after some time it's go to B position. That means it's covers some distance by motions. And the rest we can say, when object does not move its position, like we can see man on the road, and we can say that he is at the rest position. And we will discuss type of the motion. First is rectilinear motion. We can say that it's a translated motion. Rectilinear motion, as the name indicates, it's a linear motion. Like motion will travel in a straight line position, and it will never change the direction. Like we can say that this, we see here, object travel from A to B. It is rectilinear motion. If object start from the A, it change the direction B, and after B point it goes to C. It will never a rectilinear motion. How you see? See, it's change the direction at this can to B. So we can say that in rectilinear motion, object never its object will never change the direction. And see here, we can plot graph distance versus time. Distance on y-axis, time on x-axis. We will get the a uniform speed graph. And the second time motion is circular motion. When object move in a circular motion. Okay? So we can say that object is a circular motion. A force acts towards the center. This force is centrifugal force. It's always act towards the center. Okay? And circular motion is basic. We can see when a child targets a stone and move like, I am enjoying. And the third type motion is periodic motion. Periodic motion we commonly see in our lab, school lab. Just like we put the motion of a pendulum. Pendulum, when we displace pendulum from its main position, it will go A point. Then after some time, it will repeat its midpoint and travel to goes to B point. After some time, it's move like 2 and 4, its main position like A to B. Then we can say that this type of motion is periodic motion. Motion, we can say that uniform, non-uniform motion. Uniform motion is when object move with a constant speed, is known as uniform motion. Non-uniform motion, when object change its speed, like first hour the speed is 5 km, then after 3 hours the object changes speed like 7 km, then we can say that this object is non-uniform motion. So today we covered basic of motion and time.